In this video, I discuss the fuel atomizers or a fuel injectors used in a engines. So first I just revise little bit that. In this chapter I start with the fuel supply systems. Okay, so fuel is first stored in a tank. From tank it is go to the filters. Filter to it is go to the pump. And from the pump, that is a high pressure fuel, is come to the injectors, and from the injectors it is finally supplied to the engine cylinder. Okay, so in a construction, here you see that is the various part of this fuel injector. Okay, so first the fuel is entered from this passage. So here you see this is a passage, this is another passage. So fuel is entered from here and go back down, and at the down parts here this passage is closed by using this nozzle. Okay, and this nozzle body, outer part is nozzle body, and this is the nozzle valve. So when this nozzle valve is moving upper directions, at that time the diesel is spray to the cylinder. When nozzle valve is in bottom positions, so this passage is closed. So how to operate this nozzle valve? So when we moving in upper directions, so this is totally nozzle valve. Okay, so this is the nozzle valves, and nozzle valve here connected with this spindle. Okay, and this spindle is connected with this spring, and this spring is further connected with this filling pins, and here the adjusting screw. Why this adjusting screw is provided? To adjust the tension of this spring, and according to these tensions the valve motion is controlled. So the liquid fuels from the fuel pump enters to the combustion chambers through the injectors, means between the engine cylinders and between the pump, that is one component, it is the injectors. The main functions of the fuel injector is atomize the fuel and distribute such that it make homogeneous mixture of the air and fuels. Suppose we talking about the diesel engine. In a diesel engine, after the end of compression stroke, that is the air is there. Okay, and we spray the diesels. So when we spray the diesels, first diesel is atomized. Atomized means it is divided in a small droplets. Then after these small droplets of the diesels are distributed to the whole combustion chambers, and it's make the complete mixtures of the air and fuel. It is known as the homogeneous mixture. Means in every cylinders the proportions of the diesels and air is constant. Okay, it is called as the homogeneous mixture. A fuel injector which is commonly used is shown in this figure. Now before moving ahead, I request to like the video and subscribe the channels for watching the more video, or you visit the playlist for watching the more video related to IC engines as well as the mechanical engineerings. For IC engines, various link is provided in a top right screen of your mobiles. From the I symbols, you access the various playlist of the IC engine. So how it's work that we study here. This is a zoom portion of this bottom part, means for a nozzle body, nozzle valve. So here you seeing in a zoom portion. Okay, so you clearly understand it. The nozzle valve is lift up. When it is lift up, okay, so no any mechanism is provided for lifting this nozzle valve. Okay, it is thus lift up due to the pressure of the fuel. We know that the fuel coming from the fuel pump have a certain higher pressure, like 70 bar or 80 bar or 100 bar, okay, or more than 100 bars. So minimum 70 bar pressures of this fuel is there. Okay, so this fuel is enter from this fuel passage. To this passage it is reached to the bottom near to the nozzle body or a nozzle valve. Okay, so due to high pressure fuel entering at the bottom of the valve, the fuel is injected in a cylinder through the nozzles. Means this high pressure fuel in this passage is applied to some pressures, and due to this pressure the nozzle valve and the spindles are moving in upper directions, and it's compressed this spring. Okay, and when this nozzle valve is moving in upper direction, at that time the fuel is supplied or a fuel is injected inside the cylinder. The pressure of the fuel is falled as it is injected to the cylinder. Then what happen? Nozzle valves move down under the spring force. So when this nozzle valves moving upper direction, at that time spring is compressed. But when there is a no diesels in this passage, at that time what happen? The here pressure is reduced. So nozzle valve is moving in downward directions. due to here tension is sated due to the spring force, and close the nozzle inlet to the inlet fuel passage. Means when this nozzle valve is closed, no fuel is injected inside the cylinder. Thus, the fuel supplied to the engine is cut off, means no fuel is supplied to the cylinders. Any higher pressure fuels leaking past the plunger of the nozzle valve is fed back to the fuel tank through the outlet fuel passage. The adjusting screw help to adjust the tensions in the spring. So, thank you for watching this video. If you learned, then like the video, subscribe the channels, and don't forget to share with your friends.